Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a Nanoblock set. I've been seeing these in stores for a long time and I thought they were kind of going to come and then go, kind of disappear off the market because it's a novel little idea. This is the very first time that I've had one of these in my hands that I've actually owned. I actually didn't buy it. My wife bought it for me, and so because of her generosity, now all of you get to share in my experience of checking one of these things out for the very first time. This is the Praying Mantis set, comes with 120 pieces. And because this is my first time looking at Nanoblocks, I'm gonna spend a little extra time just kind of looking at the parts and getting a feel for the system in general. 120 tiny little parts. Wow, this is wild. Looks like all the parts have the same height to them. So I'm just gonna go ahead and, you know, compare this to what I'm most used to is Lego. And they've got some very interesting distinctions. It's not just scaled down Lego. These really are different parts. So for instance, here you've got a 1x4, you've got another 1x4, but they're different. This one has curved edges. This one has rectangular edges. Similarly, here's just like your basic 1x1 block. Or brick, right? Then they also have these. So it's kind of like everything is a plate in this system, it looks like. It's pretty interesting stuff. You got some clear pieces here. You've got some, looks like joint, ball joint pieces. This looks like it would go in here, like so, yep. And it has a little bit of friction, so you can change the angle. You can imagine that's gonna be used for a head. And we've got some semi-transparent pieces also. With the nice bright green. It's a very, very nice color. Everything is kind of hollow on the underside, but they do have these kind of strengthening ridges in them, which basically gives you extra stiffness without adding a whole lot of plastic and weight to them. Let me go ahead and build this thing up and see how it looks. Wow, that was a different experience. Very different from any other building system that I've used. Let's take a look at this thing from some alternate angles. You can see that the legs are very spindly, and you can start to see how the rounded edge pieces compared to the square edge pieces are used. There's that joint that we saw early on. Got the abdomen, a little bit of clear section used in there for a little bit of different style of texture. That's a pretty good shape for the bug, the insect overall. Not too bad. These really represent the folded up wings on the sides. Has a little bit of poseability to it, but I hesitate to try to pose it because let me tell you, this thing is fragile. Fragile. Things are bendable. I mean, look at that right there. It's just bendable. Pieces can come out. You don't want to just push down on things because everything will just explode. It is something that absolutely requires that you have a very gentle touch. Really take your time. Be patient. You can see just how light these pieces are. The thing is, these pieces don't snap together. They push together. They slide together. Let me show you what I mean with some of the extra pieces. Oh yeah, there are a ton of extra pieces included with this set. So that's very nice. They give you plenty of extra stuff. And I'm sure a lot of that is used towards alternate builds and combination models and such. But just as an example, okay, here we go. Let's take two 2x4 pieces, right? A very common piece size. And let me show you actually right now, comparison in size between one of these and a Lego brick. There's your size comparison. Yeah, quite a bit of difference. It's half the size. It's exactly half the size, which is curious, but that's the choice they went with and it works in terms of getting things really smaller. But watch this. Normally with brick-based building systems, right, you could take these, overlap them like that, and they snap together. Well, these did not snap together, they pushed together, and watch this. I just slid that a little bit. I just slid it. You can slide this anywhere you want along the way. So because of that, parts don't just go together a certain way. You actually have to be extra careful to make sure that they line up properly. And I had a lot of trouble with that personally, just from lack of experience in the beginning of this build for the praying mantis, especially with the body, because you have a lot of little parts. Just imagine when you have little parts, stuff like this, that's going to be put in the center between two things, which is an interesting thing, being able to go in between studs like that. But you've got something like this, and now those are supposed to line up. You have to do it perfectly. So it really requires a lot of patience. It's a very different sort of thing. It's not just like Lego in smaller scale. So that's interesting to me. And you know, it makes sense, a little bit more sense, I think, when you realize that this was fully developed in Japan, where culturally people in general are given more respect for the idea of taking your time and having patience and exercising craftsmanship and working towards excellence in doing a thing, whether it be with your mind or with your hands. So if you kind of get into a gentle, calm kind of mindset, it's going to be a very interesting experience just doing it. It's almost like doing origami, or I don't know, I'm trying to think of what else it could be like building a very small model ship, like a ship and bottle type of thing. You know, it really requires fine, slow, patient work. So it's more about, to me, it's more about the experience of building than the end result or how you get there. Or I should say the parts that are used in getting there. This is a $10 to $12 set, depending upon where you get it. And I think it was really interesting. And I'm very happy with the value there, given the experience. And you get all these extra parts. And I highly recommend that anyone who gets any of these sets tries to put those parts to good use. You know, make something just with them, or try to add to the set that you got in the official model to make it more intricate and more personalized. Interesting stuff. Nanoblocks. You can find out more about them at, for folks in the US, go to mynanoblock.com, or you can just Google Nanoblock and find out a little bit more about them. They have a bunch of sets that are out building different things, from animals to buildings and famous landmarks and such. So very interesting experience, and I'm very happy to have been able to share that experience with all of you for my very first time. So that's it for this look at this set. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. I certainly did. And I hope that you'll stick around to watch more videos as they come out, as I'm always coming up with new stuff, reviews, and also custom builds from various types of brick built and block based building systems. Catch you later.